I have here the Hioki DT4256. I'd just like to share with you the features of this digital multimeter, which I think makes this a compelling choice or alternative to the other branded digital multimeters like the Fluke 117 or 115, which are themselves excellent digital multimeters. It just so happened that the DT4256 cost lower than the Fluke counterpart. The DT4256 has an auto-hold function, which is not an ordinary hold function because, as you can see, this will hold the value on the screen once the measured parameter stabilizes. You can also see that the functions around the function selector, there's only one function per selector position. There are no nested tasks here. So this is actually preferred by many electrical practitioners. It has a dedicated backlight button, which makes this very convenient to access the backlight. Now, I have seen reviews and feedback of other users who complain of short backlight duration and a backlight control that is not easy to access because it is nested with the hold function. Here you get a special and separate dedicated backlight button. It has a category 3 rating of 1000 volts and category 4 rating of 600 volts. You have an AutoVolt function which automatically makes a judgment of whether you are measuring AC or DC voltage. You have, of course, the continuity, the resistor test function, the capacitor, the diode function. And a special note that I want to say about the diode function is that the open circuit voltage of the diode testing here is 5 volts DC. And here you have the function slot for the external clamp-on AC probe. You get the current measurement function for DC and AC up to 10 amperes when you want to measure current by connecting the test leads in series with the load. And then finally you have the volt detect function, which is simply its version of non-contact voltage detection. And it has 2 levels of sensitivity, which you can access by pressing the range button. This one now is at low sensitivity, and this one is at high sensitivity. You have here the min-max button, and this is very useful if you want to keep track of the changing values of voltage, like voltage dips, for instance, during thunderstorms. You have the filter button, which is useful if you want to filter off high frequencies when testing or measuring voltage output of variable frequency drives. And you have the rel button, which allows you to zero the display before you start the measurement. You have the range button, which allows you to change between manual reading or automatic detection. And your display here is a multi-information display. For example, at the top here, it gives you the frequency reading, the true RMS voltage reading here, a very bold and a clear display on the center, the simulation of an analog bar graph, and the battery state is always displayed at all times. Let me just do a very quick functionality test. Here, I set my selector to the AutoVolt function. This function automatically makes a judgment of whether I am testing a DC or AC voltage source. This one detects DC, 9.3 volts DC on this battery, and without touching anything, it measures 236 volts AC on my outlet here. And one thing to note about the AutoVolt function is that it also serves as a low impedance voltage measurement function, which is useful when you want to eliminate the effect of ghost voltages or stray voltages. For diode testing, the threshold of the display is 0.15 volts to 1.5 volts. However, the actual open circuit voltage for diode testing is actually 5 volts DC. It will only display 1.5 volts up to 1.5 volts because of its limitations of the threshold on the display, but the DT4256 can actually light up diodes like here in this set of color diodes, because of its 5 volt open circuit test voltage. That's 0.509 millifarad or 509 microfarad. Millifarad or 180 microfarad. So depending on your needs for capacitor measurement, you may find this fast enough or rather slow. But if you're only measuring one or two capacitors at a time, I personally don't have any problem with the speed of the DT4256 in measurement of these small capacitors here. Another notable feature of the 4256 is its AC clamp-on probe slot here. Now, Hioki manufactures its own AC clamp-on probe accessory, but it is also compatible with these two clamp AC clamp accessory, the Fluke I400D and the even lower cost UNI-T CS06A, both of which has similar output ratio of 1 millivolt per ampere. All you have to do is simply change the range of the 4256 to match the output ratio of 1 millivolt per ampere of these clamp accessories, and that range happened to be at 200 ampere. Now, although you won't be able to measure up to 400 amperes, you won't be able to utilize the full capacity of these AC accessory clamps of 400 amperes. If you only want to measure up to 200 amperes, this is perfectly fine. Now, I have here my line splitter, which is connected to a small load. Testing first the UT CS06A on the X10 leg. I get a reading of 2.6 amperes. Let's try also the Fluke I400D. The same reading of 2.6 amperes. So this makes the DT4256 a very versatile digital multimeter for use with other brands AC clamp accessories like the Fluke I400D and the UNI-T CS06A. The continuity function gives you two indications of good continuity: the audible alarm, as well as the visual indication, which is the red LED light. As to the speed of latching, I think that for me this is not a problem. This is fast enough. The continuity of the 4256 should be useful for checking and testing continuity of de-energized circuits and protective devices in Category 3 and Category 2 locations. Its voltage detect or non-contact voltage detection function at the low setting. If it doesn't detect at low setting, simply change the value to high setting using the range button. Now, non-contact voltage detection works by detecting the presence of electric field, and that may not always be possible. So as much as possible, if at all accessible, always test for the presence of voltage by using the voltage function and placing the test leads in the test object. The Hioki DT4256 has a very stable tilt stand, and it does not fall off if I press these buttons. Although Hioki already manufactures their latest DT4261 digital multimeter, they still continue manufacturing the DT4256. In fact, based on its serial number, my unit here was manufactured in Japan last December 2022. The meter is powered by four AAA alkaline batteries, although I prefer to use rechargeable nickel metal hydride batteries because they are leak resistant. It is protected by one high-speed, high-capacity fuse rated at 11 amperes full load, 1000 volts, with an interrupting capacity of 50 kiloamperes on AC and 30 kiloamperes on DC. In spite of the really neat features of the 4256 that I really like, including its lower cost when compared with its Fluke counterpart, there is one thing though that I'm not very excited about, and that is when measuring resistance. It makes an incessant beeping while measuring resistance, and that can be disturbing to neighboring people. For me though, it is not a deal breaker, and you can completely disable the buzzer by a power up option, pressing filter while turning it on will disable the incessant beeping. However, it will also turn off the beeping during a continuity testing, which is very important, and you're left with only the red LED lighting to indicate good continuity. So there it is guys, the Hioki DT4256 True RMS Digital Multimeter in a nutshell. If you have comments or suggestions, please drop me a note below. And I'd appreciate it if you can support my channel by hitting that like and subscribe buttons. Thank you for watching. Stay safe.